magicians often say the hand is quicker than the eye. Well, tonight we'll show you a magician who can truly make that claim. News 4's abilities reporter Art Humphrey introduces us to Dwayne Fisher, believed to be the world's only totally blind magician.
We're going to try to do a little bit of magic for you today. You ready for some good magic?
Yeah!
There's nothing that makes me a good magician because I'm blind. The only thing it does is perhaps make the magic a little bit more mystifying.
Dwayne Fisher lost his sight in a hunting accident 2 days before his 18th birthday. During the struggle to put his life back together, he discovered the joys of magic. Now at 42, this Flint-based magician travels the state performing for clubs, parties, and schools.
I always could visualize things. I could paint a picture in my mind and see it before ever having to go and do it. And so I will take the things in my show and I will decide what illusion, if you will, I want to create in the audience's mind. I'm seeing it in my mind as I do it. And sometimes I'm seeing the wrong things and I hope they don't.
Dwayne's eyes on stage are his two daughters, Rebecca and Shelley. During a recent performance in Royal Oak, the Fisher family had an especially appreciative audience of elementary school students.
You know, magic like beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. There's nobody more beautiful than children when it comes to magic because they already believe in magic, so anything you do, is they think it's wonderful.
The wonder of magic captures a child's attention and imagination. Dwayne Fisher uses that opportunity to leave another message.
If you're going to be a hunter, or if you're going to shoot, target, practice, whatever, learn how to use a firearm from somebody who knows how to use one right and safe.
Dwayne Fisher was blinded by gunfire 24 years ago, an experience he hopes no child has to go through. But for those kids in the audience with visual impairments, he has another message.
It's a chance to inspire the youngsters to let them know in their own way that they can be anything they want to be to the extent of their own abilities if they just want to get out there and go for it.
Even though Dwayne Fisher may not be able to see his own performance, it will never stop him from waving his magic wand.
With my abilities report, I'm Art Humphrey, News 4.
Art!
Where'd he go? That's cute.
What I'm going to do, Tony, is have you pick a card, okay? Now, how I'm going to do this is I'm going to run through the back of the cards with my thumb like this. At any time that you want a card, I want you to holler, stop. Okay? Got it?
Yep.
Here we go.
Stop.
Real good, Tony. That was card number 58 by my count. The problem is I've only got 52. Now, we had 53, but we removed the Joker. He's sitting down there. Okay? I'm going to repeat these instructions to you. I'm going to take my thumb and run through the back of the cards like so. Anytime you want a card, just holler stop, okay? It's not difficult. You got it all figured out now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here we go. Ready?
Stop.
Do you mind if I get started? Thank you. Now we're going to need a good-looking young lady to help us out here, Rebecca. Nobody older than 130, though. Young lady, we got one? Let's bring her right up here. Yeah, let's bring her right over here.
Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
Carrie.
Mm-hmm. Pleased to meet you, Carrie.
Nice to meet you.
Step back just a little bit there. Come on over here with me, Carrie. Do you know what this is?
Not exactly.
Good.
I'm not going to put my head in there.
No, of course not. This is something. You like tossed salad, Carrie? Say yes?
Yes.
Good. This is something you make some great tossed salad with, Carrie.
Is that right?
Right now, Carrie thinks she likes Jell-O pudding real well. Yeah, something soft like yogurt salad. Now, Carrie, you can dice up a head of lettuce. You can cut up a potato. You can mince up a rutabaga. But why anybody eats rutabagas, I don't know. Let me see your hand, Carrie, so I can get the whole pretty girl's hand. Other way. Over. Good.
Okay.
Yeah, if you put those real close right there, you can even trim those right into your salad.
Mm.
Yeah, but those fingernails kind of get stuck between your teeth. Make lousy croutons. You might want to pick them back out, all right?
All right.
Now, we don't want you to worry, Carrie, so we're going to practice first, all right?
Sounds good.
Rebecca, do we have something we can practice with?
Yeah.
Carrot. Good choice. Heaven knows Thumper probably won't be needing this. Looks like a trick carrot. Is this the rubber carrot or what? I think this is the Kessel special here. Yeah. Right. Ever seen a carrot make a left-hand turn? Look, we could tie this guy in a knot, I think. Double-jointed carrot with scoliosis. Look at that. Okay, Carrie, check it, make sure it's a real carrot. You can take a nibble if you want. You want to bite that carrot?
It smells like a carrot.
Is that a real carrot, Carrie?
I would think that's a real carrot.
It's a real sick carrot, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Weird-looking carrot. Okay, We're going to put him right in, and we're going to drop this blade harmlessly right through this carrot. Carrie, okay?
Okay.
Trust me, she says, right. Trust a blind man with a blade? Uh-uh. Here we go. See, no problem, Carrie. The Rebecca, I heard something bounce off the stage by my foot. Darn. Maybe a little scotch tape or some crazy glue right there, and I don't know. It's dripping something. Carrie,
yes.
I'm so glad you volunteered to help me out. Have you ever heard the expression, the show must go on?
Yeah.
It just did. This is show business, Karen. We're going to try this with you, and hope it works just a tiny bit better than it did with that carrot, okay? Kneel right down there, kind of like you're going to say your prayers. In fact, it probably wouldn't hurt to say a few.
What am I going to do?
Kneel right down there. There you go. Kneel down there. I'm insured. I hope you are. Yeah. Ah, that's good, Carrie. All right. Carrie is excited about this. I can tell. Are you ready, Carrie?
I think so.
You think so? Any last word? I mean, anything you'd like to say before we do this? Help. I thought so. Okay, on three, we're going to drop the blade on Carrie. Here we go. One, two, three. Wait for what? Is it time for a commercial? That's not for what you're thinking, Carrie. That's not to catch your head. That's in case you lose your supper.
Oh, okay.
All right, on three. Here we go. One, two, three. You know, Carrie, I was thinking about something just before we did this. Did reach right around the outside here with both hands? Right around the outside here. Carrie, you've probably told your youngsters lots of times the importance of following directions.
Yeah.
You can set a great example tonight by following these directions. Grab onto your ears, Carrie, and do not let go for any reason whatsoever.
My ears?
Ears, just northeast of your nose, south of your... There you go. It really upsets people when things bounce off the stage and land in their lap, if you know what I mean. And we don't want that to happen. I get charged extra when things fall in the orchestra pit. Okay, pretend your life depends on this, Carrie. Because we don't want you to lose your head. You ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. One, two. See that thing moving below your head, Carrie?
Yeah, I do.
Thank God, that's the blade. I don't see a thing down there myself. You see that reddish, gooey, orangey stuff that looks like carrot juice?
Yeah.
It's blood. No, it's... Please be carrot juice. You can let go with your left hand, Carrie. Now you're right. Mm-hmm. Now wiggle both ears. Cheat, use your fingers. Use your fingers. Wiggle your ears. Good. Don't make any quick moves for about 2 hours and 15 minutes. Big hand for Carrie. All right. Now, Carrie, there's probably going to be a lot of people out here who want to check the back of your neck. I'd charge them about $5 a piece if I were you and make a buck on this deal.
Okay.
We have something for Carrie? Yeah. Big ad for Carrie. Thank you, Carrie. A great sport. The Spears of Death. Are you ready, Rebecca?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Cheers. I've got.
Flint, you're watching WFUM Flint.
This is Michigan Magazine with Del Vaughn and Barry Stutzman.
Once again, and welcome to another edition of Michigan Magazine. I'm Del Vaughn.
And I'm Barry Stutzman. Our first stop in Michigan Magazine is to Caledonia Elementary School, Del, where we visit a very amazing man, the amazing Dwayne Fisher. He's a magician, and he's one of a kind.
Interesting man. And then it's a trip down to New Hudson, where I'll talk with Pam Paulson. She is a wood-burning artist, and she does bone deco. Mm. What an interesting lady. But first, we're going to make that trip with Barry over to Caledonia.
It's an early Wednesday afternoon, and Michigan Magazine finds itself in the darkness of the backstage area of the Caledonia Elementary School Auditorium, watching as mysterious luggage is being brought on stage from outside. We follow the line of black boxes outside where we see more items of mystery being unloaded from a utility vehicle, including colorful trunks on wheels. It looks amazingly like items a magician would use in an act of illusion. Well, that's exactly what it is. But today, we're not going to visit with just any magician. He's a special person with an extraordinary story to tell. Soon, the man we've been waiting for makes his way onto the stage with the aid of an assistant. This is the amazing Dwayne Fisher of Flint, Michigan. He's the world's only known totally blind professional magician, mentalist, and illusionist. Blinded by a shooting accident on the eve of his 18th birthday, Dwayne fought the odds and the critics who said it couldn't be done to create a show of magic and illusion that continues to captivate audiences of all ages. Today, Dwayne would perform a special program before the students of Caledonia Elementary. Despite his special needs, Dwayne insists on supervising and directing the actual pre-show setup. He himself making sure everything is precisely where he wants it. The success of his show depends on such accuracy. In each show, Dwayne routinely uses audience participants. As we watched, Dwayne briefed today's assistant, Tara, on what she would need to know about the illusion known as the Spears of Death.
Face me. Okay. grab the box right here on these sides. We're going to turn this one quarter turn this way. When you say stop, we'll get that quarter turn done. Good. You say it loud so I can hear you. There'll be music going here, okay?
Okay.
They can't hear us. Now you step right over there.
Okay.
I'm going to be right here. I'm going to pick this up. And we're going to put this tube through the box, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And once I do that, then we're going to put four. There'll be a tube there with five spears in it.
Mm-hmm.
Look at them. There are four long and one short.
Yep.
You're going to pick up the four long ones one at a time. So grab a long one.
Okay.
And hand it to me. Handle him first.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, nope, that's the side. I want you to hand it to me. So this part right here comes in my hand, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, pick it up again. Hand me a spear. Excellent. Nope, no, no. Can't make sure it's facing that way. Okay,
okay.
Hand it to me. That's good, just like that. Then
okay.
I can turn around and see and put them in, okay?
Mm-hmm.
After I finish that, I'll say cross behind me. Always cross behind me. So cross behind me, right over there.
Okay.
Now we're going to turn this right back to the front, just the way we started.
Okay.
Good. Say stop when you get there.
Stop.
Excellent. You're going to be right over there. These tubes will not be in our way.
Okay.
They'll be out of the way. Then you're going to hand me four long spears again. Exactly.
Magician Dwayne Fisher has taken various versions of his magic show on the road, appearing with some of the top names in the entertainment industry. His presentations have mesmerized all ages, from corporate executives to elementary students. Today, his Spears of Death would be the finale to today's show before Caledonia Elementary students. The show will be tempered with a strong message from Dwayne of how guns and drugs kill. That's no illusion. After Dwayne was satisfied that all was ready, his assistant, Beth, introduced us on stage.
Barry, this is the amazing Dwayne Fisher.
Dwayne, it's
Barry,
a pleasure meeting you.
Now, my pleasure.
This is really a pleasure to meet one of Michigan's finest magicians, and we have a unique man who has something that he has everybody here that is totally amazed because he's not only one of the finest magicians, but he's blind, too. How long have you gone without sight, Dwayne?
About 33 years now.
Mm-hmm. Tell us the story behind the story, how you got into the world of magic and illusion.
Desperation, starvation. Poverty.
Uh-huh.
Well, I was shot the night before I turned 18 by a careless hunter.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, you know, my world changed completely. I had no aspirations of, you know, being an entertainer doing magic. It was mm-hmm. one of those things happened completely by accident. A friend of mine had taught me a card trick just for something to do one day.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, you know, just sleight of hand. There was no Braille cards. And you can't do Braille with, you use sleight of hand, you know, with Braille dots get in the way.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And magicians are always suspect anyhow with a deck of cards. So, you know, a blind man with a Braille deck would definitely be suspect.
True.
So I just used some regular bicycle cards and we had a lot of fun with the sleight of hand. And I thought, you know, there might be some possibilities. Just kind of curious. So I pursued that and got started doing magic just for fun. And then a little bit later, to actually make some money, and eventually, I tied in the theme of the, you know, the guns and drugs killed. That's not an illusion.
Mm-hmm.
It was not an original thought.
Mm-hmm. But it's a thought that the audiences that you're performing for today can take it to heart, and it'll make a real good impact on them.
Gives them something to think about from somebody who's been there.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Now, this is a tough situation to be able to learn magic. In your situation, it's tough to learn for anybody, but in your situation, it's who coached you? How did you know if you were doing the right things, and how did you know it was going right?
Well, if they booed, it was wrong.
You started with card tricks then, is that it?
Yes.
Okay, and then you graduated to some very...
Mostly self-taught. Went to certain conventions, and, you know, there's... Somebody said, you know, there's catalogs and magic props, and the equipment is extraordinarily expensive because it's a monopoly market. You either pay the price or you go without.
Mm-hmm.
And you try different effects. And to me, I prefer to think of them as effects, not tricks, because you sequence things together to create an effect, mm-hmm. not just a trick. And a lot of the props are not special, just expensive. And you try them out, you try different routines, and you find things that work for you, you know. Most magicians buy a lot of stuff that they wind up putting on shelves because it just isn't right for them. There's no way to know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The world of illusion is a fascinating world, and it's got quite an impact in the state of Michigan because there is so much attraction to the Coleman area of Michigan mm-hmm. and the Marshall area. Have you got any inspiration from those magicians that
There was a man down at Abbott's in Cullen by the name of Neil Foster mm-hmm. back in 1969 when I first met Neil. And Neil was one of the very few, if not the only magician, who believed what I was trying to do might even be possible. The rest of them thought this is ridiculous, you know. It's strictly a visual field, and that's true. And a blind man has no business doing magic, because it's never been done by anybody who was legally, well, there have been a few legally blind magicians, but none totally blind, and not to that extent. So he believed in me, and he encouraged me, and he was a real inspiration. He's passed away now, but he was a very, very talented magician, one of the best in the world, never probably heard of his name, because he wasn't one of the media people like the Blackstones and the mm-hmm. Copperfields, but he was one of the most talented magicians anyone ever want to meet. And he was a real motivational factor for me.
But here you have a whole show. It lasts nearly an hour, about 45 minutes, and you run the gamut from guillotines to ladies in the boxes, and what is key is the people who are around you and helping you and assisting you, your assistants, mm-hmm. your lovely ladies, and the people who put it all together for you. And that's a key part of the show, too, I would imagine.
Absolutely. You're only as good as the people you work with.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Which is not altogether true, because some days when I'm looking bad, it's not a reflection on them. And some days...
Now, you do quite a few shows every year, don't you? Mm-hmm. I mean, you are... Personally, you book. Do you have an agency, or...?
No, I book myself.
You book yourself, huh? And travel around the state?
The state, Michigan, Ohio, Kentucky, Indiana, Tennessee, Illinois, Wisconsin. Mm-hmm. They pay me enough. Mm-hmm. We'll go. If it's something we like to do. Right. I don't do bars.
Right.
Those kinds of atmospheres. But I do a lot of schools, I do churches, I do conventions, I do fair dates, mm-hmm. motivational kinds of things, scouts programs.
This must be really... fulfilling for you. I mean, there's got to be some inspiration that you get feedback from the audience that keeps you going.
When it works, it's nice.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Do you have kids come up and talk to you after the show?
Oh, yeah. They are always wanting to know how the effects work, of course, especially right. the Spears of Death, which is the finale. So how does this work?
Mm-hmm.
And I used to tell people occasionally how something simple would work. But truthfully, people really don't want to know how the things work. That is the magic. People are not ignorant. They're smart. It's not like 100 years ago. Magic, you could fool people. Now people are much more intelligent, much more aware, and they're not easy to fool. I try to entertain them, and if I fool them, that's fine. That's secondary. But when people actually find out how the things work, they really didn't want to know.
Mm-hmm.
They're disappointed.
Mm-hmm.
Because the magic is gone.
Fulfilling on your part, too, that you do have an impact on the kids, and you've mm-hmm. got their ear in a very special way.
Yes.
And it's something, a message that you're portraying about safety is something that they can grasp and take on.
I've got a couple of reasons I do the program. I've done this for many years, and the only reason I continue to do it, because it's a lot of work doing this show. People do not understand. They see on stage, think it's just that simple, but it's many hours to set up and tear down and blood, sweat, and tears and on the road and stuff. There's a lot of work that goes into these shows. So you got to be a glutton for punishment to be an entertainer in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
And second, I do it because I'm hoping that we can make an impact on somebody and let them know that there are things they don't want to do with their life and things that they can do. You know, this magic is supposed to be impossible. It's not impossible for a blind man to do it. I can't do all of the different kinds of magic, but I can do enough. But most of the sighted magicians can't do all of it either. But they do enough, and that's all that's important. So I try to let the audiences know that maybe there's things in their life that they could do, too, if they really just gave it their best shot, just to see what would happen. They might make it, they might fail, but they'll never succeed if they never try.
Mm-hmm.
So I use it for that kind of motivation.
Mm-hmm.
And also to remind them about gun safety. I'm not anti-guns, I'm anti-carelessness.
Mm-hmm.
Try to get them to take hunter safety classes and remind the students how drugs can be dangerous, how they can create an illusion in your mind, but not a good one. We mm-hmm. show them that with the Spears of Death. And I think it does make an impact, and they do remember some of it.
Right.
That's what makes it worthwhile.
Well, it certainly was no illusion that day as we witnessed the impact Wayne seemed to be having on his audience in Caledonia. The kids seemed enthralled with the act, and no doubt a few of them will remember the message of safety and inspiration conveyed that day by the amazing Dwayne Fisher of Flint.